Everyone knows everything is locked up. Coffee shops, clothing stores, shoppings, public parks, film theaters, basically everything fun. With most of the people inside their houses, it's a bit nerve-wracking to go outside yourself and shoot some photos or some video. It feels illegal and irresponsible, but that's not true. You can still explore for that perfect landscape or that perfect photo you've been searching for without putting yourself and others in an unsafe spot and not pissing the cops off. Hey everyone, this is A Film by André, and today I'm at my desk. I'm gonna show you some of my photos that I've been taking while on quarantine. Yes, you can actually go outside. Yeah, responsibly, of course, if you use one of these. But first, I'm gonna take you outside so the past me can explain to you how I've been feeling wandering around the city alone. Let's go! So, what's up everyone? I need to take off the mask, but first, before you take off your mask, you have to sanitize your hands, put a little bit of alcohol on your hands, and then you can take your mask safely because you don't want germs on it. So stash this away, and then gonna put a little bit more. So we're out here. This place in particular is a place where I can feel calm and I can stay away from people. That's why I can take off my mask freely, because when I'm wandering around the city, it's not safe. It's not safe to walk around without your mask. So take that in mind. So during this experiment on walking around the city while in quarantine and seeing that the city pretty much is deserted, less people are walking around, you can have an opportunity to focus on what matters in your pictures. As for me, I've been focusing on minimalism photography, and it's easier. I can take a picture of something, of an object or some building I really like without having those distractions of people and cars and everything else. Not so much people, because I like photographing people, but I don't like photographing a lot of cars. It's been great to have less cars in the city and less noise. I like going around the city taking pictures with my phones, with my earphones, and listening to some good music. So yeah, more and more I've been enjoying shooting in cloudy days, because the light is more diffused. It gives that pastel touch to everything without having hard shadows. I feel more calmer and more accomplished and satisfied with the pictures I take when the sky is like this, as you can see. For me, this is the perfect weather. By the way, are you annoyed that your glasses keep fogging up while you're wearing your mask? I got a little life hack for you. Dishwashing soap. Yep. That's real. You just put a little drop of soap in a microfiber cloth, spread it to both lenses, clean it up with a dry cloth, and voila! Though, I must warn you that this is temporary, and if you want something that lasts longer, you'll have to get an anti-fog wipe or spray. I think that's it, pretty much it, yeah. Okay, we're back. So the first photo is this one. It's a black and white photo of this statue. And I wanted to take this without any people, but for some reason I missed that person right there. But it's actually okay, because that girl over there, I think it's a girl. Yeah, it's a girl. It gives the sensation of loneliness and this deserted city. So I really like it. The tree branches going up, making this natural arch so we can focus on the main subject, that is the statue. The next one, it's one of my favorites I took these days. It's this mother with her child, and I was just seeing if I could catch something interesting, and I actually saw this round ceiling thing. So I was already trying to figure out the best angle so I could take this picture, and suddenly this mother was passing by and I was waiting for her to get off the frame so I could take the picture, and she stopped at that sweet spot, at the middle stop, so I could take a picture without her noticing it, because I'm not a creep, you know? And I want to take pictures without feeling like a creep and looking like a creep. So I just clicked immediately when she got the phone and took that selfie with her baby. It's amazing. It's actually, it tells a lot of about quarantine, because during quarantine you're supposed to be inside safely, and this mother is taking the risks and just taking a walk with her child, and well, that's a brave thing. I'm not sure if that's irresponsible or anything, but I find it interesting that she just stopped at that sweet spot and I just took the picture. I got a problem with this one. I really love sky, and this sky over here is not that interesting, but I really love living a good chunk of sky and having what's interesting down here. The problem is that every time that I noticed this, I already took the photo, and sometimes I already edited the photo. And I look at it again and I say, that's a lot of sky. I'm not sure if I like it. I mean, this is here because there's that girl over there looking at the distance, looking at the landscape, probably wondering, where are all those people? Where are all those ships that usually comes to Madeira with full of tourists and everything? That's no more. And it's black and white. You can't go wrong with it. So this one is quite interesting. I was shocked to notice that a swan was swimming in the ocean. This is very unusual in this spot. Once again, lots of sky here. I really got a problem. But I mean, you can see the three layers of cover here, and I think it's quite good. What do you guys think? Comment down below. Do you think this is good? Do you think that lots of sky is actually good? Let me know. This is probably my favorite of these past few days. It's this tree. It's this crooked tree. She's not perfect, but you can see the perfect in the imperfection. As you could see, everything is lined up, everything is so minimalistic, so clean, and then you have this tree that is crooked, that is curved, and it gives you a sense of calm, of cleanliness and everything. I don't know if that's a word, cleanliness. Excuse my English, I'm not really good with it. But this green with along with this blue, you can't get more natural than that. This is quite different, a different color palette. I chose this because this is a part of the city where you can find all of these pipes, all of this machinery. It's the port of the city. It's currently empty without any ships. I tried to isolate this top part of this machinery kind of structure, and I thought, well, if this is metal and everything and I want to give that industrial kind of sense to it, I'm gonna get rid of the blue, I'm gonna focus on the grays, and I'm gonna pinch it a little bit of green there and some bits of orange on those rusty nails over there. With this one, I really like this building. It's the top part of a lift that you can go down to a beach, and the sky was really cloudy, so I could emulate this this dreamlike feeling, this emptiness feeling, and giving that blue a punch and contrasting it on top of the sea and the sky. And the final one is this one. I was going around with a friend shooting some stuff with his drone, and I looked up trying to find where his drone was, and I saw the moon, and the moon was perfectly centered with this building over here. And since I'm a Wes Anderson sucker, of course I had to take the picture, and this is the result. I made a little bit of change. I actually took the moon and made it a little bigger so it could contrast it better. During these adventures, I took my trusty notebook and wrote some ideas for new videos for you guys. So if you want to help me making these ideas a reality for you and bringing you new content, please subscribe, like this video, and comment below. What have you been doing during this quarantine? Did you develop a new hobby? Did you try something new? Please let me know. Bye, people. See you on the next video. Bye. So, bye. Again, sorry for my English. This video took forever to shoot because I was always messing up. And today I'm at my desk. Really? Hey everyone, this bike! Bikes everywhere!